Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how I learned to use Flutter to send messages from the serial port of this Chipsee industrial tablet. At first, I wanted to make a very simple app to test my idea. When I click the button on this app, I wanted to send a hello world string, and I want to use my Mac to receive this hello world string through a serial cable and display it in a serial debugger. After some searches and with the help of Piero from Flutter Dev Discord channel, I learned I can use a Flutter lib serial port package. It can open or close a serial port, can read and write messages through the serial port on Android, Mac, Windows, and Linux. So I add the package with Flutter pub add Flutter lib serial port. There's a bug in the package in October 2023. I'm not sure if that's still there when you watch this video, but I'll just leave the solution in a comment, import the package, write a very basic layout like only a button on the screen. I return a scaffold with a app bar, and I want to have a center button, and the button needs a callback, but I haven't written that part yet, so I will just set the onPress callback to null. And this button is too small, I wanted to make it bigger. This is better. Okay, now we have a layout. How do we initialize the serial port? I don't know. Let's read the document. It says final port equals serial port with a name. This seems to be the way to initialize the port, but what is the name? He says serial port.available ports.first is the name. Well, let's see what are the available ports. I can use some print debug like print serial port.available ports. Okay, I have this many ports on this Chipsee industrial Android tablet. I can refer to the Chipsee documentation to decide which pins are which TTY devices, and I'm connecting my DuPont wire from RS45-4, so it should be /dev/TDevice4 for this 10.1-inch RK3568-based Chipsee HMI. So I will just put /dev/TDevice4 in the name. Alright, from my limited background knowledge of serial ports, I know I should open the port with some configurations like baud rate, like stop bits, like parity. So where should I set these values? Well, there isn't an example in the repo, but I think I can find some hints in the issues. In this this issue, this guy gave an example. So I copy that, change it a little bit, and set the baud rate 8 and 1, overwrite the init state with a init port to initialize this serial port, and that's it. So that's port initialization, but how to send a message, like how to write a string, write a hello world from the port. Let's go back to the repo, but unluckily the author only gave us a port.write method, but I don't know what should I put in the method, so I have to dig a little deeper. From the source code, it says write accepts a uint8 list. It's a list of 8-bit unsigned integers. So how do I convert a string to this uint8 list? Well, Dart is very new to me, so I asked Google. On the first page, there is an example. It says uint8 list.fromList and code units. This code units is from a string, so we can write a function like say hello world. I want to make sure I only call this when the port is open, and I write uint8 list.fromList hello world.codeUnits. Then I want to call this function when I press the button, so I change now to this function. Alright, I think we are almost there. Let's test it on our tablet. Press the button multiple times, and it's there on my mic. The Chipsee HMI is sending from RS45 to the mic correctly. I think this is a good start for us, but there is one very annoying bug in this code. When I close the app and reopen the app, I won't be able to send messages anymore, and I also cannot see any messages appear on the Mac. The error messages I got is serial port devices busy. I guess it's because I forgot to close the port when I queued up, and the serial port is still occupied, like we get some sort of memory leak. Imagine when you are playing some music and you queue the app, but the music is still playing in the background. I spent quite a lot of time on this bug. The best solution I found is a new feature added in Flutter 3.13, the AppLifecycleListener. So when the app goes inactive, I close the port, and when it resumes, I reopen the port. And we can test the bug has gone when we closed and reopened the app. We can still receive Hello World from the Mac. So this is one approach I find that's working for this bug. I'm not really familiar with Flutter and Dart, but I think it does the job. I haven't found a solution to this bug when Flutter hot restarts. I still have to full restart the app to avoid this bug happening when developing. So that's it for today. In the next video, we will talk about receiving or listening for incoming messages on the Chipsee HMI. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.